We've had the comedy, we've had the laughter, we've even had a few tears, but to quote Zoe Ball's midwife, what we need now is a good knees up. So, would you oblige, sir?
Certainly, but I would like someone to come and help me, because I've always sung this song with a woman, so I'd really all fancied singing it with a bloke. So, ladies and gentlemen, please give a warm reception to Mr. Alan Partridge.
Thank you, thank you. Elton, you are a legend. Your songs are admired by the many, despised by the few. They've helped a lot of people through very difficult times in life, people who've been despair or people who've been in periods of sadness. It's helped them through those moments. And I have personal experience of this because I was actually a disc jockey in hospital radio. And I'll never forget the first time when there's a lot of very sick people, the first time I played Saturday Night's All Right for Fighting. And that's the reason a lot of them were in there, actually. I'll never forget. I knew from their reaction that it was going to be a hit. I won't say they were on the feet, you know, but fingers are twitching, eyebrows are dancing, and believe me, in intensive care, that's a party. Now, of course, Sir Elton John isn't your real name. That's, of course, as we know, Harry Webb.
Actually, no, it's Elton John is my real name, but I used to be Reg Dwight, yes.
With respect... with respect, you're wrong. This came up on a question on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. It was one of the cheap ones, £100, yeah.
Alan, I should know. My name used to be Reg Dwight, so I mean, no one should know better than me.
No offence, but you have been on record as saying during the 80s you did experiment with pot. you were a pothead, and I think that may have affected your memory. Now, I have to say, one of my favourite songs of yours has to be the classic Yellow Brick Road. Unforgettable. Yeah. Follow.
No, that's the Wizard of Oz, please. Thank you.
Yeah, I know. Pinball Wizard of Oz. Can we move on? Now, Rocket Man, another favourite of mine, but some of the lyrics are, Mars ain't the kind of place to raise your kids. I don't know. I mean, who wrote that lyric? I mean, I think you want to have a word with your friend Barney Turpin, because... Who in the right mind is going to want to raise their kids on Mars? Yeah. There's no atmosphere.
Yeah. A bit like your show, dear.
Yeah, that's a bit cheap. Bit cheap, that. Yeah. Unlike your lifestyle.
But a bit like your jacket.
I think that's a little bit much coming from a man who spends £2 billion a day on daffodils. Now, on with the song. Now, it's a duet. It can be sung between two men. I've got to say, I'm very comfortable with my sexuality. I can hug a man, you know, if I'm playing five a side, you know, and someone scores a goal, I'll say, come here and give us a kiss, you big, lovely, goal-scoring man. Is that why you bought a football team? I've left my car on a meter. Can someone go put £2 coins in my meter? It's a maroon red OS bus outside Abbey National. There's a trap next to the cash point.
Take the weight off of me. Oh, honey, when you knocked on my
conversation to start. I'm not actually gay. I'll grow up.
Partridge.